Hey Design Nation, today you're going to learn how to make a stretchable dynamic block in AutoCAD. Okay, so this is what we have. It's a storefront system in plan, and basically you want this so that when we stretch this, we don't have to type so much, and this will be equal. So what we want to do is make a dynamic block to be able to do that for us. So I'm going to actually delete this and draw it from scratch. So you can see any of the quick keys that I type, they'll come up in this command, shortcuts or whatever I use. I'll try to narrow it as much as I can. So 4, 2, that's a standard mullion dimension. And then we'll just rotate this. Oop, I don't know what I just did. RO, rotate, and just copy this, do 1 and 5, and looks like I have units off, so I'll just do 5, let's do 60, and 120. Right? I'm going to draw a line here for the sill, another line here, draw a line to here for the glazing, choose offset point. 5. And then I actually have the layers set up in here already from previous, so a glazing, the architectural glazing is what I want. And I'm going to select this and make it a glazing sill, and then I'm going to leave these on layer 0. I'm going to make sure that I send this DR to the back. DRB, so send it to the back. So right now I have essentially what I had before. Started from scratch, just drew everything. So now I'm going to select all of this, type B for block, and then I'm going to give this a name, plan, storefront. Okay. So now you can see I have a block, right? I can move it around. It's one piece, the basics. And then when you want to make a dynamic block, the only difference is that instead of going to edit block in place, you go to the block editor. It's important to know that if you have a dynamic block, if you go into edit block in place, it's going to delete all your dynamic parameters. So make sure that once you have a dynamic block that you're editing it in the block editor. So once we click Block Editor, it'll open up this screen. We have this little palette over here, which is helpful for all the tools that we have. But in the ribbon, you essentially have this as well, these drop-downs, which are very similar. So I'm actually going to use the ribbon, just in case this didn't pop up for you, and use the base point to start with. So this is going to set the base point since I didn't manually set it. And it's just nice. I prefer doing it this way because it gives me a crosshair. If you set it manually when you create your block, then you won't get this crosshair. So it just makes it visual for me. And this is going to be a linear parameter. This is what we're going to be editing. So I'm just going to choose the first point and the last point of my storefront system. And it's going to ask for how many grips. I'm going to type 1. Because I just want it to be anchored at one point. You can see this little alert. That means that this has no action applied to it. So what we're going to do is select an action. We're going to use stretch. I'm going to select the parameter, the anchor point, and then essentially it's asking for a stretch frame or C polygon. We're going to use the stretch frame. Essentially you're selecting the endpoints that you want to move. So if you think of all the endpoints of your lines as being what you want to move back and forth. So I'm going to select this, because this is what I want to move here. And then it's asking for select objects. So I want this and this to move. And then you right-click, and you're good. Now to get this center mullion to move, you have to do another stretch command. I'm going to select the same parameter, the same anchor point, but now I'm going to select this center point and select these inner columns, or these inner glazing and that in this inner emollient. Right click, and now you want to go over here and click on stretch one. You can give these names as well. The distance multiplier, we want it to be half of the distance, so we're going to just make this 0.5. And this, so that's going to keep this in the center all the time. And then up here there's a little test block, so you can come in, you can test how your block is performing, it's doing what you want, and this is, so it's perfect. And if you want to do different parameters where you can do minimum and maximum, you can do that as well, but we're not going to get into that right now. So hopefully this was helpful. Oh, the last thing actually, you notice that before I, so I'm going to actually close the test block, and you can see here that this is on layer 0, and I think that's a good thing, because when you close out, I'm going to save it. So now I'm in my file, I'm out of the block editor, this is great. Now, a lot of people don't know about blocks is that they hold the parameters. So if you use a layer 0 and you pull it out, you can then use this. If you change the layer that your block is on, it'll change the layer 0 to the current layer. So you can see now that this is a glazed emollient, and that just makes it easy. So if I were to draw this line and this was also a mullion line, it's just easy to match parameters and keep your drawings organized. If you thought this was helpful, give me a thumbs up and subscribe. And for more helpful tips, head on over to www.designerhacks.com.